Hey guys, and I do mean you guys, welcome to my channel today. I'm so excited to talk to you about the topic today. Today we're talking about grooming for men. And why am I so excited about this? I'm gonna tell you in just a minute. But if you like videos that are focused on fashion, beauty, lifestyle, and a little bit of luxury for men or for women, then I would love it if you would hit that subscribe button down below. If you're not already subscribed to my channel, please do that. If you're a guy who likes this kind of stuff, or maybe you have a significant other in your life that does like this kind of stuff, then hit that subscribe button. If anything else, maybe you'll find me entertaining. Remember to ring the bell so you never miss any videos. And remember to like this video if you do like it and share it with someone that could benefit from the contents. And you ladies, if you've got a guy in your life that could really benefit from some more grooming or from some grooming tips, make sure you share this video with them. Also, you guys, make sure that you're following me on Instagram if you're not already. I do Instagram live videos on Saturday mornings at 9 a.m. Central Standard Time. I just share my week with you. I talk about things going on with me. I talk about whatever things you guys want to talk about, and I ask you about your week as well. So it's a way for us to really connect on a more personal level. Just really fun. You never know what you're going to get in an Instagram live on a Saturday morning. And so I would love to see you over there. And I also do post other content over there that I'd love for you to be a part of. So without further ado, let's jump right in. Okay, so why am I so passionate and excited to talk about men's grooming today? The reason why is because I really believe that there's so many men out there that could really go from looking average or looking okay to looking completely amazingly hot, really sexy, really great, if they just invested in their own personal grooming. I think it's so important, and I think there's some things that you guys might already know, but maybe some things that you haven't even considered or thought of that really can elevate your look and in turn help you feel so much more confident, which will allow you to go out into the world and just crush it personally and professionally in your everyday life, and I wanna help you do that. So let's get started. When we're talking about grooming, I said I have three tips or three categories I wanna talk about, and I wanna work from the top down. So let's start with your head. The first thing I wanna talk about when it comes to grooming is your hair. I want you to really think about the last time that you changed your hairstyle. Now this is really important if you're over the age of 40, because a lot of times men and women both can have the same hairstyle for a really long time, but I think for men, this can happen even more often because the last thing you might consider in your everyday busy daily life is your hair. And if you've got a lot of other things going on for you from a physical perspective that are positive, maybe you don't really think about it, it's not something you consider, but if you've had the same hairstyle for a long time, you might want to think about changing it up. Really look at different ways that you can bring your hairstyle more current. Maybe there's a different hairstyle that would make you look younger or make you look a little more vibrant or show off your face better. If you're not sure what this would be, or maybe if you do want to change your hair and you want some inspiration, all you would have to do is Google men's hairstyles 2020 street style to see how other people or other men are styling their hair this year in 2020 and what's current and what's hot in men's hair. But you might find something that really would suit you better. The other thing that I would recommend is make an appointment for a consultation with a seasoned hairstylist. And if you're not sure where to find a really good hairstylist, what I would recommend you do, how you find a really good hairstylist, ask an attractive woman. She'll point you in the right direction. And then you go have a consultation where you just spend time talking with him or her about your hair, discussing your ideas, asking them for their opinions, and really see if you vibe with the stylist. Do you like them? Do you think that they share your vision? Do you like their ideas? And from there, you can decide what you want to do moving forward. But you really want to sit down and have that consultation. The other thing I want to recommend is don't be afraid to invest in some styling products for your hair. I think that's really important, and I think that can really elevate your hairstyle quite a lot. The last thing I want to talk about when we're talking about hair is really looking at and addressing any issues you might have with your hair or your scalp. Do you have dandruff? Do you have oily scalp? Do you have other things going on where your scalp might be dry? Really look at those issues and address them and take care of them. If you do have to see a medical professional to get products or get help you need, really do that because it can just elevate your style. I have seen really attractive men that have dandruff or other things going on with their scalp, and it just is really unattractive to see that on their clothes or see that in their hair. So you really do want to address those issues. Now, if you're a man who's bald, like my husband, you really do need to take care of that as well. It's very unattractive when a man who is bald doesn't really maintain that look and they start to grow patchy hair kind of here and there on their scalp. It doesn't look good. So you really do want to be keeping up with that and shaving your head on a daily basis. Make sure that it really looks clean. Make sure it really looks nice. The other thing I want to say about this is make sure if you're bald that you are protecting your head. I really want to encourage you to wear sunscreen every single day because you don't want to get sunburn on your head and you certainly don't want to get skin cancer, nor do you want to develop those unsightly age spots that comes from exposure to the sun. So really make sure you protect your head. The other thing that wearing a good sunscreen on the top of your head will do is add a little bit of moisture so that your head doesn't get too dry. So moving on, let's talk about the face. Now let's start with the eyebrows. So many men that I see really need some TLC when it comes to eyebrows. So either you've got really overgrown bushy eyebrows that need to be waxed, they need to be trimmed, they need to be shaped, and you really do need to do that because it can change the entire look of your whole face. It can really make your eyes pop, it can really make your eyes light up, or you've got a situation like I do where I have really thin, sparse eyebrows and you need to take care of that too. I actually do get my eyebrows microbladed, which is a procedure where they can actually thicken your eyebrows through a procedure to make them look really nice. It is semi-permanent, so I only have to go a couple times a year, but it has really helped me really change my aesthetic and the look of my face. I really love it. It's one of the best things that I've done. So you really do need to look at doing that. And you really need to see a professional. Do not try to do this at home and do not shave your eyebrows. That is a definite big no-no. Now let's talk about facial hair, specifically nose and ear hair. Now a lot of guys might think that this is only for older men, but it's really not. It really depends on how hairy you are as a person. And if you're a more hairy person, really look at your ears, look at your nose. I've seen really attractive younger men that actually do have nose hairs poking out of their nose. It's so unattractive and unsightly. You really do want to take care of that, you guys. It can make a huge difference in your appearance and it can really make a huge difference in your confidence level. And this is kind of gross and graphic, so I apologize. But also, if you've got those little fine nose hairs that you haven't trimmed and taken care of, sometimes when you sneeze or blow your nose, you can have some unsightly discharge or drainage or boogers caught in there, and it's really, really gross and you may not know, so we definitely don't want that. So you really do want to take care of that. The other thing with facial hair, if you do have facial hair like a mustache or a beard, make sure that you're trimming that, maintaining that, really combing that and conditioning that the way you do the hair on your head. And also really consider your facial hair. Is it time to change that up and try something a little different with your facial hair that might change your look a little bit? Maybe that's just something to think about. Now let's talk about the skin. Men really do need to invest in skincare, especially as you get past the age of 30. It becomes really, really important. You do need to be wearing sunscreen every single day, even in the winter, is really, really critical, especially for men, because most men I know don't wear foundation. They don't wear concealer like women do. A lot of foundations for women do have sunscreen built in, so we already have that protection in our makeup, but because men don't have that, it's really important to invest in a good sunscreen. And if you're a no fuss kind of guy, then I would recommend a gentle everyday cleanser and a moisturizing sunscreen at minimum. You really do need to do that, but you do need to invest in a good skincare routine. I would recommend a gentle everyday cleanser. I would definitely recommend an eye cream and possibly a neck cream, but also sunscreen is really, really important. And it's also really important to address any skin issues you have. Do you have rosacea where you have some pigmentation issues in your skin? Do you have acne issues? Do you have really dry skin? Do you have eczema or psoriasis? That's another reason why investing in a really good skincare routine is important, because it can help you deal with and clear up some of those issues. And I highly recommend that you go see a dermatologist or an esthetician to help you clear up some of those issues. Don't be embarrassed or afraid to do that. That's what they're there for. And trust me when I say it will absolutely boost your confidence. You will look and feel so much better. And like I said, then you can go out in the world and crush it in your personal and professional life. Moving on, let's talk about your teeth. Now I realize these days a lot of us are wearing masks a lot of the time, but that doesn't mean that people still don't notice your teeth. How many times are you on a Zoom meeting? Are you on a FaceTime meeting with somebody that your teeth are exposed, that you're talking, that you're smiling? You wanna make sure that you don't have food stuck in your teeth. That's obviously really unsightly. But the other thing that that does is that really does cause bad breath. So you really do wanna make sure that you carry around flossers or little mini toothbrushes so that you can take care of that after you eat. Research has also shown that oral issues in our mouth can be tied to heart conditions and other things that are really, really dangerous and can be really deadly in our body. So we do really want to take care of our teeth and really manage our oral health wisely. The other thing that I'm going to recommend when it comes to teeth is really taking the time to whiten your teeth. And how often you do this will really depend on your lifestyle. If you're someone that smokes or that chews tobacco, or like me that drinks a lot of coffee, then it becomes more important. I try to whiten my teeth at least 4 times a year, and I would recommend anywhere from 2 to 4 times a year, depending on your lifestyle and depending on how much you engage in activities that could yellow your teeth. I really recommend, if you can't afford it, to get it done professionally. There's a lot of services that you can find out there that are under $100, so not super expensive. And there's a lot of deals you can find if you look for them as well. But at minimum, investing in the Crest wipe strips and doing something at home at least 2 to 4 times a year makes a really big difference. Now, lastly, moving on to the body. Make sure that the clothes you're wearing are clean. Make sure that they are relatively wrinkle-free. Make sure they're tucked in and they're worn the way they're supposed to be. Make sure that they are stain-free as well. And then at minimum, you want to make sure that you smell clean and fresh. But I would highly recommend that you invest in a signature scent and you wear cologne. Now, I was never a fragrance wearer. I really shied away from that. I really didn't want to offend anyone. And I wasn't really good at picking out fragrance. And I always was afraid that I would wear too much and I'd smell like one of those old ladies that wears too much perfume, and I didn't want to do that. But recently, this past year, I've invested in some fragrance, and I have a couple signature scents that I really like, and I can't tell you how much it's really boosted my confidence and how much it really lifts my spirits. I really love it. And keep in mind, if you've got loved ones at home, kids or a spouse, when they smell your signature scent, it really just makes them smile. They really enjoy it. It's just something for them that they really find comforting. Or if you're somebody that has to travel for work or you're away for any reason, having a loved one be able to smell an item of clothing or something that you've worn that has your signature scent on it is really nice. It's really comforting. It really can enhance your grooming and elevate your style. So you guys, those are my 3 grooming tips. Let me know in the comments below if you do any of these things already. Also, let me know, are you going to start doing any of the grooming tips that I recommended? I will try and link some products below in the description box for you, so make sure you check that out. Make sure that you let me know if you have any questions or any comments on today's video. I would love to hear your feedback, and I would love to answer any questions that you have. I'd love to help you in any way I can. Just know this is coming from a woman who loves men and who really believes that you can be the best version of yourself. I want to see you look and feel your absolute best every single day so that you can go out in the world and crush it personally and professionally, and you can be that really stylish, sexy man that I know that you are. So with that, I hope you enjoyed today's video. I will plan to see you in my next video, and remember, beauty or handsomeness begins the moment you decide to be yourself, and confidence is the most important accessory you can wear.